Okay, so again, no, so we are moving to our module 2, Advanced Geographic Information System, and this time we are discussing more, or will be performing more of the exercises in GIS. So for this lesson, lesson 1, thematic maps. Okay, so our expected outcomes for this class is to first to describe the methodologies, no, available to parse data into various classes for visual representation in a map. So we are dealing with data. No, and then we are going to visualize that data in a map. Well, as well as, no, in connection, we are creating thematic maps integrated with real world data. Okay, so first of, no, let's just define first. Insani siyang. Now we have the term coroflet maps. Sa doon coroflet maps. So thematic maps na siyang coroflet. No, but it is shaded. No, the maps are shaded with graduated colors to represent some statistical variable of interest. Also, it is a mapping technique that uses graded differences in shading, color, or symbology to define average values of some property or quantity. So later, no, we will experience, no, in sa paggamit ni mag-grad, no, we'll use shading, color, symbology, and then apply to map, no, depending on the data. So nagavari ang inyong output depending on the data that you are going to utilize. So first we have sa doon siya one of the methodology sa pamaagi sa pagrepresent sa kwan, no, or a technique, no, in coroflet maps, in representing coroflet maps, equal interval. So what is an equal interval? It is a coroflet mapping technique that sets the value ranges in each category to an equal size. Take note, an equal size, no, or ginatawag ko na siya equal step classification method. Okay, equal step. So it divides the ranges of attribute values into equally sized classes. Okay, take note, equally sized classes. Okay, the number of classes is determined by the user. So kita yung magbuot. So later we will be able to see that. Makita nato na ang how are we going to determine the number of classes for each attribute value, no, for our map. Okay, so we have an example here. Okay, this is for United States of America nga map. So using equal interval classification, okay, the data is quite obsolete na siyang data, but no, mamumuni siya nga sa ano, reference na ako ang nakuha. So 1997 US county population data. So no, say US, then ilang population, and then girepresent siya through coroflet, no, map, no, coroflet map, or it is a thematic map. So the theme here is about population, no. Okay, as you noticed, we have the legend. So ako na siyang get the interval. So wala siya nagligas man uno, kung nailigas di nagmay lang, pero equal interval, no, halos equal from 67 to pila man siya, 1,903,921, no, kung imo nang i-minus ng first sa legend niya and then the second legend number, no, third, so makita ninyo equal interval ang gigamit. So that's why this technique is equal interval. And there are other 4, no, techniques in classification, but later nato siya i-discuss, no, after this if we have time. No, let's just focus first on equal interval classification. Okay, so sige, so let's do the exercise. Okay, so are you still there? Napa ba? Please follow me.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So this time we are going to use. I have extracted, actually. Grabe, na busy ko. Pinangita ay og shape files and data, no, for this exercise, because I want the setting to be in Philippines, no, Philippine setting ta and local. So I have found, no, I have found a double sur ng mga files, no, that we are going to utilize for these exercises and for the later exercises, because mas guwapo mangod siya if localized ang atong trabaho. no? And we can really appreciate it, mas ma-appreciate na to itong trabaho ba if ginabuhatan na to ang ato ang locality. Okay, so we have here, she files for the barangays para sa Dabsur, Davao del Sur. And then also, I have, sige lang, ako ning, after this class, I will upload this in your Google Classroom. Okay, and as well as we have this data, kindly take note na lang or check the recording, no, of the website. So we have Philippine Atlas or philatlas.com. Yan, darigikan na nga ko ang statistics, statistical data. Okay, actually, ang ilang na-upload dari is, ang pinaka-latest is 2020. Okay, so for this exercise, I'm going to show you how to create a core flat map or thematic map for population. Okay, atong data, take note, ang population, ang data nga atong dala-dala on this time is population. So, and then I found it at philippineatlas.com. Okay, so to begin. Let's just focus on ano ha, kay actually kung ito ni per barangay, no, because ingani magud siya guys, I'm looking for shape files para sa municipality, ng municipality lang mga divisions ba, no, but I couldn't find nga per municipality, no, per barangay siya ba, up to the barangay level ang pagka-divide sa shape files, no, or kaninga mga vector files, so that's why for this time, we will just focus. Dili ta mo focus sa entire Davao del Sur because mahuman na lang, mabtan tag alas 3 ani, no, mahuman na tong klase binutag data. And so mag-focus lang ta sa Digos. Okay? Digos nga data, population. Okay? So, in this map, so i-click lang na nimo ang kaning link na per municipality and then magawas ang data. Yan. In Digos, we have 26 barangays. Okay, nga ni magod siya, no, for, I didn't find any CSV file na pwede na ako ma-integrate or ma-embed sa akong shape files for barangays, kanina barangays, no, wala ko kitang CSV files nga pwede, but I can create, no, I can create, but delete na ako siya ma-create pa this time. So, late, sunod siguro, akong ipagamit sa inyo, ha, okay, ang i-demo sa inyo ha is delete mo gamit ang CSV file, external CSV file. What I will do is I will touch the attribute data table sa inyo ha, sa ato ang shape file and or shape file or vector data files for barangay, and then i-edit na ko siya dito, i-butang na ko ning population. Okay, so nakuha ra ba ang ako ang ato ang kuan direction for this exercise? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, nakuha ra. Isa rin nakasabot. But pasabot ba? Wala ko yung CSV file gamiton karon. Ang hilabot ko diretso sa attribute data table. Okay, so, wait lang ha. Let me start from the scratch. Oops. Sige. Can you see my GIS?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So, we will get the vector data mode data files from our barangay. I will use the DBF. Now, as per instruction ako last time, DBF is kanimang good doon na siya ay kauban, no, ng attribute data table. That's why we use the DBF. Pwede mo po shape file. So, by practice, ako DBF din ako ginauna o gamit. Okay, so this is for Davao del Sur. And this, it is divided for each barangay. Okay, so it's just improve lang natong kundi kay kabanag brown. Just improve the color. Anyways, mga ilabtan mga po niya ang color. Yan, so if we are going to wait lang ha, let me check the attribute data table. So attribute data table, these are the fields na siya ID, ISO, name. So take note the name. 0 is Philippines, name 1 is Davao del Sur, name 2 is for municipality, and then name 3 is for barangay. So, name 3. I intended to use the name 3 as labels. Okay, name 3. So, let's check the labels na part. Yan. And then, I will use the name 3. Yan. Name 3. Yun, so if you notice, we have, yan, Malalag, Santa Cruz, to malalag. But let us focus in lang ha, Digo City, para di kita malangay. Ayun. Tama ba ni? Zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone. Wala, may zone 4 ang Digos. Di tumaong, takaragig ko. Tara. Yan. Yan. Okay, that is Digos. So, so inside buhato na to. So, looking at our data. Yan, for Digos. So, let's, ako siyang i-input dito sa itong attribute data table. And then, so if you notice, kani siya nga data table, no, limited to names lang siya for province, municipalities, and barangays, and their IDs, okay, and sa nga region. Pero wala siya any other data nga pwede na to i-match, pwede na to i-visualize. So, since I'm going to, this time we are going to visualize the population data for Digos, di man yung municipality ng Digos, but no city of Digos. So let's check ha, city of Digos or Digos City, yan, Digos City. And we can actually, as I have mentioned last time, we can edit the attribute data table. So can you see my mouse cursor, kaning toggle editing mode or control E?
Yes ma'am.
Okay. Yes ma'am.
I click lang na nato siya.
Yes me.
And then ay oh yes, tapos naata dari sa yan. And if you hover this one kaning na pencil yellow na plus new field, no, ang yahang comment is new field or control W. So we are going to add a new field or a new column. Yan. So I can name that one as population. Population ang atong theme karon or our topic. And then population, daghan man, no? Per barangay ba? Daghan ba kayo? So, okay na siya siguro 10 digits. Pila mo na 10 digits. Abot na ba nagkuan? 9 ang 1 million. So, wala pa na. Abot million ang per barangay, no? So, okay na siya ang 10 digits. Okay? And then, the type is whole number, integer. Yan. Because, di ba? Population is a whole number. Di man tama po, hindi nga. Population is napulo og tunga. So, whole number, integer. Okay. Yan. And then, so population. So, akong hinahinayan siya, butang. Okay, so, first, Digos, Playa. Yan, Playa. Asa itong Playa? Playa, 19234. So, it's quite, 19234, it's quite, ano siya? Medyo, sige lang. Then, i-enter na ko ha, upon inputting the integer, i-enter na ko siya. Then, I save dari, tapad sa, no, tapad sa katong edit toggle. So, save na ko siya. And then next is Balabag, 1434. Balabag, 1434. And then, save. And then, para mapaspas ko, ako na lang din ako ipakita sa inyo na yung i-move ni sa laing screen ako ang population para mapaspas lang ko. Okay. Yan. And Binaton, 2645. See. Next is Kugon, 9650. See. Next is saan niya? Colorado. Colorado 3301. See. Dawis, 58. Then, 581419, Dulangan, 119. So, again, ang akong data ng ginadulaan is 2020 National Statistics Data. MP3712. And then, Kapatagan, 15. Laganda, namuyo sa Kapatagan, no? 15,000 sila. Lungag. Ay, kiagot. Saan ito? Okay, lungag. Asa mo yung lungag? Shoot, mapuntaan niya eh. Asa mo yung dapit yung kisay kabaluan yung barangay lungag? Lungag. 652. Mahayahay. Mati. Four to seven. San Agustin. San Jose. San Miguel. Ang dagandag muna sa San Miguel. San Roque. 1659 Suong. Suong. 1602 Ay no. Sinawilan. Suong. Kapitata. Tiguman. Yan. 3 de Mayo. And then, Zone 1. Zone 1, or 2. Zone 2. Zone 3. Okay, yan. So that ends for Digos and then save Antaga. Okay, let me double check. Okay, so kana. Okay, gapunta ni siya hot do na to siya butang tanang barangays. But because we are going to expect ka, inganin na lang expectation na to because there are data in our attribute table nga nakanal. So that's why delicate ka perform and tawag ni gwapo nga classification this time. Okay, again, because atong shape file is the entire Davao del Sur and then per barangay, so dapat unta wala tayong null values here. And let's just tawag ni let's just kanang national values, but let me wait lang ha. Pwede man siya sa lahat, pwede actually pwede ta mag-delete ng mga rows eh. Pwede na to i-delete later ang mga rows na dili na to included for kuan para wa tay null values sa atong population. Okay, so let's just check first inside gawas ano inside output no. We just focus on the Digo City. Okay. So next, so in sa atong buhaton, so nahilabtan na nato ang attribute table. So what is the next step for this? So let's go to our yan. Before moving on again, natay technique ka pwede buhaton, no? Dili ta mo hilabot sa open attribute, I mean, dili ta mo hilabot sa data attribute data table. Dili ta ka mag-isa-isa dito ba? Pwede ta magbuhat o CSV files. Kopyaho na to ang naas sa attribute table, data table. Kopyaho na to ang rows, I mean, ang column. And then, we can input there our data. Pwede na siya yung ana, no? But for this time, katog, hilabtan lang na to ang attribute data table. So next, what we are going to do is to atong ipakita ang classification. So double click the layer. And let's go to symbology. Let's select graduated. Okay, graduated. And then the value is, take note, population. Graduated ang symbology. Ang atong value is population. And then let's try precision of 1. And let's, sige, kani, color ramp. Can we, let me change this one. Hindi ko ganahan ang pula. Siguro, mga, yung blue siguro. Yeah. Kana. Okay, shades of blue. And then, sige. And then after that, nanatay color. Color ramp, so we are going to select the mode for classes. Okay, if you notice the ang yang mode, default mode is equal, no, equal count or kani atong count or kani atong gina quantile man dari no. Yeah, let's check the kaning, or let's use the equal interval. Yan equal interval. Okay, and we use the classes 5. Actually, di ba katong ingon gani ha, kita ang mabuot kung pila ka buok ang classes nga to ang gamiton. We can choose 4. So 4 lang po na kabuok ang iyahang classes. Kita, kinakuha ba? Nakuha ba so far?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, miss.
Okay, so if you want,
yes, ma'am.
Gusto ko gagmay pinupino ba? Pinupino ang imong pagkuan sa ma-capture gini mo nga, colorful kayo nga ko ang thematic map at mga gagmay ng interval makuha. So you can go higher classes. Okay? Sige, for this time, for the sake of example, 5 lang sa. And then let's apply. Yan. Oops. Yan. Pero, you see, na yung puti, no? Hindi ko gusto na yung puti. Wait lang, ha? Let's use another color. Pwede tanggalan yung puti. Ilabitan na tong color, ha? Hindi ko ganahang puti, eh. Sorry. Move na to, ha? Okay. Darker daw. Okay. Apply. Yan. So, okay. So, una, no? Barangay Digos. We have our... yan. So, for barangay, we have our heat map from Barangay Digos. So, hindi pa kaya nato siya mapushit kasi kulang pa ni. So, what to do next? Okay, na-pass sila so far? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, to appreciate this one because di na to siya kayo ma-appreciate kaya wala pa na-display ang iyang population. No, ato ang gilabel mang god is the name sa barangay. So, what are we going to do? We have to use the print composer. Okay, so just go to project, new print layout. Yan, tanga na ito pangalan o kani population. Digos. Yan, and then, so magawa si print composer. So, insa i-click na ito kang print composer. Okay, so by default si print composer, if I'm not mistaken, this is an A4. A4 na size na paper. So, if you see this add map, nakita ninyo ang akong cursor. Hello?
Yes,
miss.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Just click the add map and then
yes,
drag.
Ma'am.
Drag ninyo asa dapat sa inyong paper ang inyong hang map. Okay. Like what I'm doing. Kani. Ayan. So, na ako yung mapa diha. And then, we put a little title. So, add label. Ayan. So, we will edit. Title. So, Digo City, 2020 census, or, census, or, isa ba yung proper term, population na lang. And then, sige ha, full font, kuha na ito gamay, okay, sorry. Tapos, sige, okay na. And then, kulang pa siya. And then, let's put, say kulang sa akong kuan, thematic map. Say kulang. You can tell me. Hello. May tao, wala na.
Meron pa ma.
Say kulang.
Population.
Say kulang.
Legend.
Okay, good. Legend. So, how to put a legend? You see here, no? Add legend. Ano lang? John Legend. Oops. Yan. So, we have our legend. Okay, so, Gwapo siguro sa akong rearrange. Ay, gamay. Wait lang. Isa po, hindi mo masapaw. Ayan. So, yeah. And then after that, so save na to. So layout, import, export as image. Yeah. So population digos. Okay, so 300 DPI. So leave as ano lang sa no? Pwede rin na to na edit. Leave as default lang sana and then save. Okay, so ang check ha. Yan. So I have my choroplet map or thematic map. So isa man yung pinakadaghan dari o pinakadaghan o population ang zone 3. Wait. Zone 3 apply wala yung name. Saan yung mga Y name di ay? Naiway name, no? Ay, Actually, sa ano ni siya, pag-ingani gani, guys, so sa shape file na siya, ng pagkabuhat nila, na ay walay, wait lang, asam ni dapit tong, ay, okay, wala na, nga no, zone, analagi,
Pagamyan na siguro ang, kwan, ma'am,
sa label. QGIS ni mo, ma'am, i-adjust ni mo.
Wait lang, tanaw na to, tanaw ha. Ah, nagsapaw siya. So, wala na kuha ng ruparan. No? What do you think?
Label size.
Ang label niya. Label size. Tama. Atong ko na ng label size. Just... Sige, so you see do. Ito lang i-check. Validate na to. Para lang... Asa na to? Text. So, hindi daw. Let's check. So, ano na ba? Shoot na batanan. So, let's do again. Okay. Lobby? Oh, huwag siya na siya tugtarong. Pag-abot niya yung point composer. Kasi nawala. Tapos, saro parang tas lumayo. San Agustin. Ana. Okay, so okay, pangitay pa agin niyo gi-drag lang nako siya. Dako nga mas dako nga area sa inyong pen composer. Okay, sige. Question so far? Naapas ra ba? Naapas ra?
Upload ba naman ang
yes, ma'am.
Video?
Oo, yes. Okay, so, let me go back to my... Ayan. So, question? Question? Okay, so nga na lang, no? Kadali, magbuhat o choroplet map or thematic map. Wala question?
I-upload to ni mong folder sa Anami sa Google Class po.
Yes. So, our next exercise, para namoy pangutana, our next exercise, you will do a choroplet map. You can do for... sige. Dili sa ito mag, hindi sa ito mag-province kayo mo. I don't know kung naman makuha nga data, pero you can get data which, kamo yung mamili, asang mga manguha sa, naabay available sa inyong munisipyo, no? Or you can just go through the internet, no? Just Google data, makita ang data for your you will choose your municipality. So I will give you the shape files or the vector files for the entire Davao del Sur, katong gigamit na to ganiha, and then you just choose a theme or topic for your municipality. Okay, that's our next, that will be your exercise for this week. Pangita mo og theme or topic with corresponding data na in which as your theme for your thematic map nakuha ninyo. So sa inyohang municipality, pangita mo og theme or topic na pwede ninyo ma-display in your thematic map. Also, para ma-display ninyo ang gusto ninyong information or theme sa inyohang map, you should find the corresponding data para na. Like for example, if you are going to display the number of dengue cases for 2021 in Matanao, okay, if na per barangay, if na amo ana nga data, sige, you can do that. Or, shall we say, a number of, tag-asaman mo, Matanao, okay, per barangay, number of cases sa kuan, sa COVID-19. So, pwede siya nga na, no? You get the COVID-19 cases per barangay for the year 2021 sa Matanao. And you can do that, no? Actually, daghan kay pwede ninyong nga topics na madula-dulaan, no? Or theme. But the challenge is, how are you going to get the data? So, if the data is available online, no problem, no? No problem. Very, it's easy for you. But if the data is not available online, so where can you get the data? Okay, primary data or secondary data? We have already discussed that in our previous lesson. So it's up to you. Sige, question. Hello. Hello. Wala na?
Wala, ma'am.
Wala.
Wala na, ma'am.
Wala tayo katulgon, pero katulgon mong tanan, naghigda mong siguro mong tanan. Wala na, ma'am. Wala na, bitaw ha? Okay, wala na. So then, I will post this video recording after this, after we end this meeting. And I will also upload the materials for your koan, for this exercise. Okay, so wala na ha? Okay. So, going once, twice, thrice, wala na. So, I will end this meeting. Okay, bye class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.